only key that opens the door. You are the owner of my soul. The bush that burns and never consumes, that's glory. What shall I render to you, O Lord? I will bow down and worship your name. You are God. Oh, you are God. You are God. You are the eyes I used to see. The only key that opens the door. You are the owner of my soul. Push that burden that never comes. What shall I render to you, Lord? I will bow down and worship your name. You are God. Hey, you are God. You are God. You are God. You are the eyes. You are the eyes I used to see. The only key. The only key that opens the door. You are the owner of the bush that runs. What shall I render to you? I will bow down and worship your name. You are God. You are God. You are God.
always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order had passed away. The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." The word of the Lord.
We hear about another important quality, this, the know that Paul and Barnabas formed a really effective team in evangelizing the world, but it can be easy to forget that it was not always easy for them, and it was not always totally successful. They experienced very real struggles, things like being looked at skeptically and even being tossed out of synagogues. They experienced being shipwrecked on one of their missionary journeys. They experienced being misunderstood by the apostolic community in Jerusalem. And so, when we heard in today's passage that, quote, they strengthened the spirits of the disciples and exhorted them to persevere in faith, change, it is necessary for us to undergo many hardships to enter the kingdom of God. They were speaking from their own personal lived experiences, and they brought a very important perspective to things too. They called the church together and reported what God had done with them and how He, God, had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. It was the conviction and the experience of Paul and Barnabas that their labors were done not simply as exercise, but of their own will, their own energies, efforts, desires, and plans. They were simply instruments of the work of God. And so they were able to persevere because of their conviction that God's work and God's will and God's design would ultimately unfold in God's plan. Stories of human perseverance have been many throughout the story of the human experience. Take, for instance, Thomas Edison. He was reported to have said, while still experimenting, quote, "I have not failed. I've just found 10,000 ways to make a light bulb that will not work." How about that? He's finding the bright side of what God did there. Or how about this person? Have you ever heard of Walt Disney? Well, as a young man, Walt Disney was fired from a local newspaper where he worked as a cartoonist. His boss believed he lacked creativity. How about that for being accurate in assessing the personnel on your team? An early animation company that Disney started failed, leaving him in dire financial difficulties, and despondent and with nothing to lose, Disney tried Hollywood. There too, things were not easy. He faced a barrage of rejection, was told he would never make it, and he was told that Mickey Mouse, his passion project, that was destined to fail. But Disney persevered. We can tell many more stories of perseverance throughout human history. That same kind of perseverance season of Easter, we are especially aware of our baptismal vocation as disciples of Jesus, and so we make use of the Apostles' Creed, the creed we profess on the day of our baptism as a form of our profession of faith. And so together we profess, I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, Father Almighty, from there He shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body,
suffer in any way, and for
We offer you, Lord, the bread of life. as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with each other a sign. gracious, may we present to your people, we pray, O Lord, that those whom you have imbued with heavenly mysteries may pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace and love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in singing our recessional hymn, number 500.